Hi everyone, and welcome to this video where I'm going to take a first look at the new beta content, for Oxygen Not Included, in the catchily named Public Testing Update 522820. There are quite a few new additions to go through, as well as many improvements and fixes. Going back quickly over the last update Clay gave, they announced they were not working on a second DLC, but were instead looking to add more content to both versions of the game, and this is the first of that content. Here's the forum post that I've linked in the description with the many changes introduced. I'm not going to read through all of these, but I'll show you the big new bits of content very shortly. There are some interesting smaller changes, such as now being able to rename rockets in both versions of the game, so make sure to have a read yourself. To enable this content to try it, right-click on Oxygen Not Included in your Steam library, go to Properties, Betas, then select Public Testing. This will then update your game to enable the testing content. Be aware that this is likely incompatible with saves from the released versions of the game, and also be aware that these versions will have bugs as the devs test out new ideas, and you can submit any you find through the Clay forums to support development. Now to get straight into the new content, let's start with the story trait system. As I record this, it's not very clear what this actually involves, as there is very little information given in the post. But there are two new buildings that can be found on the map, which are the Somnium Synthesizer and the Critter Fluxomatic. The Somnium Synthesizer is the bigger and flashier of the two, and brings some new elements with it. Firstly, there is the Pajama Cubby, which can endlessly dispense pajamas. These are obviously clothing, but reduce athletics by 8, and drain stamina at a rate of 10% per cycle. What they also give is the ability to generate dream journals when sleeping. A dupe will need to sleep for a total of 300 seconds to make one journal, which is 4 cycles if you have the default 3 schedule slots of sleep. The Somnium Synthesizer needs to be dupe activated, and then you'll need 25 dream journals for it to start analyzing. Analyzing takes 1,500 seconds, or 2.5 cycles, and it will also consume 500 grams per second of oxygen to do this. The maximum aptitude buff is given as the Somnium Synthesizer analyzes dream journals, but this ends once complete. After all that, it becomes fully restored, but it's not clear how to reset this once it's fully charged. The buff itself gives plus 5 to athletics, strength, science, piloting, and machinery, as well as minus 25% stress per cycle. I think this is probably not working as intended, so we'll have to see how this evolves during development. If you are able to get the buff continuously, then it could be quite a powerful addition. The second building is the Critter Fluxomatic, which is found somewhere else on the map and also needs to be activated. Once it is, it will collect critters that wander onto its left side and analyze them, giving you a new database entry when it does. In total, it needs 5 different critter species to complete its analysis. Note the critter morphs do not count as different species. After 5 have been analyzed, it changes its function and will now modify a critter's morph. When a critter goes in, it will come out as a new random morph, and then go on cooldown for 1 cycle. To be honest, I don't think this is particularly useful, except in rare situations, but it's an interesting idea. We'll have to see if this gets expanded upon, or linked to other elements. The next big change is the addition of the new kitchen room and spice grinder building. The kitchen room itself doesn't give any morale, and only enables the use of the spice grinder. For a room to be a kitchen, it must be between 12 and 96 tiles big, and have a spice grinder, fridge, and an electric grill or gas range. The spice grinder is a new building, and needs a dupe with the level 2 grilling skill to use. It comes with 3 spices in the base game, and an extra one in the Spaced Out DLC, with each of these giving a modifier to food. Firstly, there is the freshness spice that extends the spoil time of food, although I'm not clear on how much by. This is made from mealwood seeds and salt. I don't really think this is so useful, as deep freezing food for infinite storage isn't too challenging. The other three spices all give +3 to a specific stat for one cycle. Rocketeer for rocket piloting, Brawny for strength, and Machinist for operating. I'm showing the recipe for all of these here. The spice grinder can only make one spice at a time and is selected at the top. Which food can be spiced is chosen in the filters here. Overall, the buff seems weak for the amount of work it would take to make, so I think this needs to be made stronger to be truly worthwhile. And the last big change is for plug slugs, which are only found in the Spaced Out DLC. The basic morph has been given some changes and now produces power more consistently and can eat refined metals, which are more easily renewable. This could definitely make them more useful, but beware that they also no longer drown, so if you're trying to farm them for food, it will be inconvenient. But the bigger change for plug slugs is the introduction of the two brand new morphs, the Sponge Slug and Smog Slug. These morphs have increased egg chances when the slugs live in liquid or in unbreathable gases respectively. Both of these new morphs absorb material during the day and release it into pipes at night, so behave like pumps. The Sponge Slug will absorb any liquid, and the Smog Slug any unbreathable gas, meaning any gas except oxygen or polluted oxygen. Then at night, if they are sleeping on a liquid or gas pipe, they will empty it into the pipe. I have done a quick test, and I recorded both slugs consuming 19 kilograms of material over the course of the day. This averages out to a pumping rate of about 30 grams per second. Unfortunately, this would mean 17 are needed to match a gas pump, and a huge 333 to match a liquid pump, so really, the uses are very limited. It may be possible to use them in rockets to capture unwanted gases, but you would also have to ensure the slug slept on a pipe to vent it, which would be challenging. And that's all for my first look at the new content in this exciting testing update. I will post updates as they're released, and even more content is added, so please hit the subscribe button to be notified when I do. I hope this maybe inspires you to try out these new things yourself, and thanks for watching.